In addition to the bank bailout plan, Congress and the White House are trying to hammer out President Obama's economic stimulus package. We want to talk about both these issues with Senator Richard Shelby, the top Republican on the Senate Banking Committee. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Harry.
I understand you are not happy with either of these packages. Let's talk about TARP or whatever you want to call what Tim Geithner was talking about yesterday. What's your biggest objection?
Well, first of all, there was nothing specific in the plan. He had nothing really to say to the American people, the Congress, or to the banks. He basically admitted this. He wasted about 3 or 4 hours of the Senate's time, and we want to know where the specifics are, and he doesn't have them. And I think he's trying, Secretary Geithner's trying, but they're in uncharted waters. But they've got to do better than this. It sounds to me that this is similar to what Paulson did on TARP 1, mm-hmm. and that's unacceptable to the Congress, unacceptable to the American people. They want transparency. They want to know who's going to benefit from this. Are they going to benefit? Is it going to make the banking system
Senator, should they have waited? Should they have waited and come out with something that had some real bones on it?
Absolutely. You know, I think on both sides of the aisle in the Senate Banking Committee, people were appalled that he had really nothing to say.
My other question, because this is still waiting in the wings somehow, doesn't there need to be a floor put underneath this entire mortgage crisis? When is that going to happen?
Well, that's the key to all of this. I believe our economic woes are the banking system. People don't trust the banking system now, especially the Wall Street firms who caused a lot of the problem. We've spent billions of dollars, and they're still not loaning money. The mortgage undergirding all of this are the problems in the mortgage business, the real estate thing. We've got to attack that, and this plan yesterday, mm-hmm. I think, was vague, indefinite, opaque at best.
These bank CEOs are going to be testifying today. Their British counterparts actually apologized yesterday in front of Parliament. Any chance that these bank CEOs are going to show any remorse today?
Oh, I know a lot of them. I don't think they'll show any remorse, but they should, because a lot of the people dealing in the financial centers of New York, they caused most of the problem, and now they want to benefit from it. We've got to watch the taxpayers' money here.
There you go. Senator Richard Shelby, we thank you for your time this morning, sir.
Thank you.